Well, I use knots all the time. I love rope and knots, and I want to show you a couple that I find the most important, and I want to show you how to use all of these together to tie and secure a load. I'm not a sailor or a yachtsman or a mountaineer or anything like that, so I'm just a humble woodworker that likes to use rope to secure lumber or steel whenever I'm bringing it back from places. And so I'm going to show you these knots and how to use them all together to really quickly bind and tie just about anything you want down securely to a truck or a trailer. The first is the bowline, or sometimes I'll revert back to my Texas twang and call it a bowline. But I think this is the most important knot that anyone can learn to tie, because this knot may save your life. You can tie this around your waist really quickly if someone has to drop you a line, and you can be pulled up by that without it cinching up and becoming a noose and pinching you in half. And it's just the foundation for so many other really great knots. This is the sheep bend. It is the best knot for tying two ropes together to create a longer rope. It's really easy to tie and really easy to untie. All of these are really easy to tie and untie. That's the beauty of a good knot, is that it's really easy to untie also. So the sheep bend is also really fantastic because you can tie two ropes of different sizes together really quickly. So when I buy rope, and the rope that I use in my truck and trailer and that I just keep around my shop, I always buy it 5 meters long, about 16 feet. And that's as long as I want to mess with. Otherwise, things get tangled, and you know, I end up having to do a lot of coiling and storing. So I buy stuff 5 meters long, and then if I need a longer rope, I just use a sheep bend to tie them together. And I'll show you that. And the Alpine Butterfly is there's really no other alternative to this knot if you want to tie a loop in the middle of a standing piece of rope. And when you tie this, you can clip onto it or pull off of it in either direction, and the knot will absolutely guaranteed not collapse on you. And then the half hitch is just a way to tie off excess rope and to just make sure that these knots aren't going to come loose after you've tied them. Now, the sheep bend is a really simple knot to tie. The Alpine Butterfly, when you look at diagrams of it, it looks really, really complicated, and it is complicated to tie it, but I'm going to show you a shortcut that I actually learned online, and it is just brilliant, and I've actually suppressed my old way of knowing how to do it because I saw the shortcut on YouTube, and I'll make sure that I give that guy credit when I post this. And then the bowline is always a pain whenever you see somebody do it, because it asks you to form this loop in the rope. And I'm going to show you a shortcut. I don't know if I developed this. I'm sure other people. I've never seen anybody else show this shortcut on the bowline, but I'm going to show you a shortcut that just makes it tying it just a snap. And it allows you to do it in the dark. You could do it with gloves on. You don't even have to see your hands anymore once you get that memory into your hands. You don't even have to watch your hands to do it. So let's just start off with this first, and I'll show you how to do it. I've got two ropes here. I've got a blue one, and then I've got this old dingy white rope. So I'm going to keep tying things in different ropes to, you know, make sure that you see what we're going for. So let me just tie the bowline here in this first. I'm going to tie my way, and then I'm going to explain why my way is a little different than what you see traditionally done. So you can see that it's just one motion and you're done. Let me do it again fast, and then I'm going to show you many, many times slow. So I'm not even going to really go into the way that you always see it traditionally shown, where you form the loop and there's the rhyme about, is that it? Yeah, there's the rhyme about the rabbit going up the hole and blah, blah, blah. But this is asking you to have to tie this knot visually. So it's asking you to form this and then see where you've got to put the rope through the eye. Now what I'm doing is I'm forming that eye in one motion. Just like if you were going to tie a knot. Here you start the rope, and as you turn the rope under, look, that's where you form that loop. And you're done in one motion, and then you just bring it around and back down through, and you're done. it's a fraction of the time, and so much easier to do in the dark or in an emergency situation. And you also can, you can also better judge where you're forming your, you know, how big a loop you want. You know, so if you're, if you need to toss a rope out of a canoe to toss to somebody to help them, well, you can tie one about body size really quickly and then toss it to them so they can slip their arms through it and get it up underneath their arms if they, so you can pull them if they lose strength. But again, look, just, you come over and then in one motion you just roll and there's your loop. So you're forming your loop as you're tying your knot. So instead of just tying a standard knot, here you're just forming that loop. And then it's just as simple as just coming back around and right back down through. But I've never seen anybody show this, so I'm hoping you this helps you, because I've tried showing this to my wife for years and she just has a hard time coming up with the bowline. And you know, even with the shortcut, I mean, knots are, they're not easy. You have to make a picture in your head, and well, I don't know. I think it's more just getting the memory in your hands. But here, so just lay it over, and as you grab it, look, you're turning it and you're forming that loop. Let me do it in the blue rope so it'll be easier to see, maybe. I'm not sure which one it's going to be easier. So here's my short end. So all I do is lay it over, and as I come around, see me forming the loop right there. And it's already in there. So I'm not having to come in here and then stick it up through there. I'm forming the loop and threading the loop at this in one motion. So if you were stuck somewhere or injured and you needed to, see, I'm not even looking at my hands, I'm just looking at the camera right now. So there it is, that quickly. So you'd, otherwise, what do? You're trying to form that loop as you're having it around and you know, come up through and do that in one motion, now you're set. Really a good knot, very important to know.